Hey guys, what's up? So after two whole months, I'm proud to tell you that I've finally been able to get into Ginvest. And as promised a few weeks back, I was gonna do this even outside Ginvest, investing directly through Atram. And Atram is the same fund management company that GCash courses its investments through. As mentioned in that previous video, I already encountered some roadblocks along the way. I had some trouble in verifying my account, but after some persistence, I was able to finally do it. And I think those problems actually brought out the best. Without those problems, I wouldn't have discovered Seedbox Philippines, which ended up offering a greater suite of investment funds that aren't currently available via GCash. So in this video, I wanted to give you a quick run through of the step-by-step process of first how you can invest via GCash, and number two, I'll be showing you later how you can invest directly via Seedbox Philippines as well. So without further ado, let's go. Let's find the GCash app from my home screen and let's wait it to load up. Entering my MPIN. All right, we're now in the main page of the GCash app. I've loaded this beforehand just so that I have enough money to input in these investments. So let's look for Ginvest. Ginvest will be under financial services. All right, so let's find the funds that I want to get into. So I'm selecting this Atram Global Technology Feeder Fund. I'm trying to find the GCash app. Now has the cutoff times. It still doesn't. So let's go into the page and select it. I'm presented here the user agreement forms. I don't think we really read this. I don't think we really read the fine print. So there are two boxes here that we need to check before proceeding. Clicking on proceed. So now we wait for the one-time password. Okay, so taking note of my one-time password and inputting it. All right, so looks like I can finally get in. I'm trying to put in at least 2,000 pesos. And one more checkbox before proceeding. Alright, just a disclaimer that this is not an insured product, so that's okay, we know that. Also listed here would be the cutoff periods. I think it says here 4 days. Is it before you actually get credited the fund? So, I don't know the standing of the fund after 4 days because the US market might be going up and down. So let me go back and since I just really want to try this, I'm just gonna go with 1,000 pesos, guys. Okay, so that's equivalent to 4.89 units. And yep, we're done. Buy order placed. It's as easy as that. Okay, we're getting the SMS from GCash. All right, it looks like I'm invested. So I can see the deduction made on my account. Since I want to try the other funds as well, let's go into Ginvest again. So here I've selected the Atram Global Consumer Index Fund. It's pretty much the same process that I showed you. Putting in the one-time password. We can now proceed in buying this. And as last time, I'm only going to put in 1,000 pesos. I agree to the said buying terms. 5.18 units, so it's a bit more than the previous fund. So let's proceed. So great, buy order placed and we're done. We've invested in the two funds for GCash. So here's the email that I got at April 26. I actually enrolled for this at April 21. Now since April 21 was a Wednesday, I got the email only on April 26, which I thought was a bit of a delay, but in reality it was actually 4 business days. The account was open exactly as listed, so that's 4 business days. Keep that in mind so that you can properly time or manage your expectations properly. Alright, so that was fairly easy. After my previous ordeal in verifying my account, investing via Ginvest was actually quite easy. That actually took seconds of my time. If I didn't go through the previous problems, it would have taken that quickly as well. And as promised, I'm also sharing here with you how you can do it directly via Seedbox Philippines. As mentioned in my first video, I couldn't schedule my KYC call until April 26. So for Seedbox Philippines, that's actually the bottleneck. The actual KYC call via WhatsApp It was 30 seconds for something I waited for 30 days. It was a pretty quick call. You just had to show yourself, your face, showing your ID. I think the only part that I found weird was that it kind of felt like a job interview. The girl told me that they would be emailing by the next day if I was successful in my application. So with that, by the next day, they sent me the email for the instructions on the next steps on how I can finally proceed with investing in the funds. And here I'm showing it to you step by step. Just as a disclaimer, the step-by-step process here is actually really important, so keep note of that and take note of the things that I'll be doing because it's rather tricky. After the scheduled call with Seedbox Philippines, I was verified, so they sent me an email on how I can finally proceed. They sent me an email with some graphic instructions on how to do it, and I think that was pretty helpful. Since their processes are a bit manual, I think that this graphic illustration is pretty useful. So let's proceed to the Seedbox Philippines website. You see here that there's actually a lot more funds that they're offering to the public. There's a handful of peso funds, US funds, and even global funds. I'm gonna try to actually invest in the same thing just to compare what the experience will be. Actually, I'm interested in this one. This is something that piqued my curiosity. This is the Atram Global Financials Feeder Fund. It is investing in global financial companies and it's targeting the BlackRock Global Funds. So unlike the two previous ones, those are tracking the Morgan Stanley Capital Index Funds. And for this global financial funds, I imagine would be mostly comprised of banks, and I think this is a nice hedge on investments anyway, so I've included the three funds here. I actually found it neat that you can put it in a sort of shopping cart, so it's similar to e-commerce, to your Lazadas and Shopees. The world markets are a little volatile right now, so I actually decided that I would only put in a total of 5,000 pesos by Seedbox Philippines in this round anyway, 1,250 each for the Global Technology Feeder Fund and the Global Consumer Trends Fund. So these would be exactly the same as GCash, Ginvest. While for the Global Financials Feeder Fund, since I don't have any investment in this with GCash and there's no way to do it there, I'm putting a bit more. So I'm putting 2,500 pesos. So this is the checkout page. Sorry, don't mind the error there. So I'm going with BDO Online Banking as my means of payment. Before proceeding, you go through the routinary OTP checks. Okay, I've got the code and inputting it now. Processing. All right, so we're in. We have the subscription summary here. The next steps are also listed. So guys, this part is actually where it can get tricky. Make sure you have no mistakes because I don't know what's gonna happen if you make a mistake. You have to make sure that you follow these steps. What was a bit of a surprise for me here would be seeing three different set of instructions, meaning that there are unique instructions per fund that I'm going into. I thought that similar to e-commerce, like one checkout can be just one payment, but apparently it's going to be three separate payments that are going to be made. So honestly, it's a little bit inconvenient. These instructions also get emailed to you, so no worries if you suddenly exit this. So following the instructions, I go to the BDO online site, log into my account, and before you pay, you have to enroll their biller. So the biller name, Atram Trust Corporation. They are of course part of the drop-down menu, and make sure that the reference number that you select is the exact one that you are gonna put under subscriber number. If you mess this up, that might be a bit of trouble. I'm sure they'll probably be able to help you out to sort this out, but I bet it's gonna take some time and you have to go back and forth. And to avoid that hassle, just get the damn subscriber number right. Make sure it matches the reference number correctly. On the part for subscriber name and preferred nickname, actually, they don't give you any instructions, so I feel like that might be arbitrary and that's probably up to you to name. So just go with whatever name that you feel that may be useful for your own records. What was a bit confusing here is that in the instructions, they didn't really tell me which fund I was actually investing in. So since I had three different ones, I wasn't sure which one. So let's enroll these, and yep, we're in. I'm gonna skip enrolling the two other billers. So yes, please take note, if you are investing in different funds, you have to enroll these as separate billers. and had to take note of three different reference numbers. Now that everything's enrolled, let's go to pay bills. Bills payment, let's go to the section of the BDO site, pay from my account, and let's select the biller that we intend to proceed with. So let's put here the amount. Make sure also, it's very important that in this part, you are putting in the right amount that the instructions gave. So, okay, just make sure you are proceeding with the right amount. For here, it's 1250, and let's proceed. Let's click on continue, and yep, we're in. I'm gonna be doing this for the other two funds that I'm investing in. The email confirmation went through my Gmail 2 days after I did this. The confirmation email went through at April 28th, so that's 2 days, that was the processing time.
All right, so how was that for you? You saw that Atram and Seedbox Philippines is actually offering a lot more investment funds out there. But as also shown, the step-by-step process is actually a little tricky. It's easy to get a lot of things wrong in terms of how you settle the payment. Quite manual, and if you're not careful, you could really mess it up. As I kept repeating in my instructions, remember to get your reference number right and match it with the right amount. That is primarily what Seedbox Philippines needs to match. If they don't match, I don't think that's something I really want to explore. So guys, just get it right. I guess another advantage of the Seedbox Philippines website was that the settlement was actually quicker. So 2 working days versus Globe, wherein it took 4 business days. So that's another comparison that you might want to look out for. Alright guys, so I hope I was able to share here with you how you can get invested in Atram funds, not only through GCash, but also through Seedbox Philippines. So which one is better? GCash came out fairly easy, whereas Seedbox Philippines, I think there's a lot of manual work that goes into it. But the variety of funds that they're offering, it's actually kind of worth it to open an account there and just see if you're up for the different funds that they're offering. And lastly, I think one of the troubles also would be the lag between the time you confirm that you want to invest and the time that they actually credit it to your account. And this remains true for all mutual funds or UITFs, whether local or abroad, is that you can't properly time and specify your entry and exit points as opposed to actual buying of stocks, let's say via eToro or local trading platforms. There could be a discrepancy of what you were expecting versus what you actually bought, or in the future with the price that you actually wanted it to be sold. With mutual funds, there's always going to be some guesswork there. There's going to be some estimation. But if you're looking at a long-term prospect, then the variances or the slight differences shouldn't matter too much because it should be seen as a long-term investment prospect. Thanks for watching, guys. If you've liked this video, please don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe if you haven't already. Thanks for watching and happy investing!